Have you ever wondered how Google Maps computes the fastest way to reach a specific place? How the right location for strategic facilities like hospitals or fire stations are determined? Or how airlines manage the logistics of having their crew in the right city for each flight? What do all these questions have in common? We'll talk about this with Laura. Ciao, Laura. Thanks for being here.
Ciao, Luca. Thank you for introducing me. Going back to your questions, what all these problems have in common is that they are examples of optimization problems. That is, problems that have several possible solutions, among which the best one needs to be found.
Oh, but in some cases, to solve an optimization problem, every possible solution has to be examined. Like to find the youngest player on a soccer field, you have to ask each of them when their birthday is. But the number of possible routes between two places can be astronomically large, like more than the number of atoms in the universe. So how can an algorithm quickly find the best solution?
The main point is that several optimization problems are mathematically structured, and this allows the best solution to be found without explicitly examining all possibilities. So the key to fast solution and to fast algorithms is therefore to find the right mathematical abstractions that can represent your data and to develop algorithms that operate on these abstractions.
Well, a map, for example, can be abstracted as a network, also called a graph, where nodes represent street intersections and edges represent the piece of road between intersections. And then finding the quickest route is the shortest path problem in the graph, a problem for which there are several fast algorithms.
Once the right representation is discovered, the problem to solve can be transformed into a mathematical problem about networks or about other structures. And then all our accumulated knowledge about solving abstract problems on these structures can be used.
And so by applying efficient algorithms to mathematical representations of the data, technology companies, airlines, logistics companies, and others are able to quickly solve optimization problems, even when the number of solutions is some unimaginably large number, like one followed by a billion zeros.
As a result, such algorithms produce huge benefits for the whole society in terms of time management, cost, and allocation of resources. They have literally changed the world in the past 50 years. To conclude, the study of optimization algorithms is a source of endless fascination for those of us who have a passion for mathematics, but also want to see the real-world impact of their studies.